All right, we're recording.
I can never remember to set up the camera until we've already got the job half done. So you get to see a little bit anyway. These are daffodils, mixed daffodils. And we've got 500 of them. And we're going to put them all in this little spot right here. Yeah, it's going to be crowded, but it's basically for nursery purposes, not necessarily just good looks. Although, I must admit, I think it's going to be beautiful. A couple walkways, and then we'll cover them with mulch. No, it don't matter. Shove it in the ground. It may or may not grow. Oh, you're lining them up? They're going to look like little soldiers.
Yep.
Yeah. No, I'm gonna stop right here and go out there. You can go back and start filling in all the middle.
Well,
because I really like to fill it in from that way, this way, in case we run out. I don't think we will, but just in case.
500, I don't think we can.
I think it's going to work out pretty close because I just put 50 in this little area right here.
$15 for 50 mixed daffodils. You can't go wrong. Thank you.
don't have enough to fill it up, I'll order more. That'll be so pretty. Can you get him?
No.
Here. Here. I had the same problem. That's a big one. That had four bulbs on it. I bet they counted it as one. Here's your what? I'm just trying to get on about the width of my hand, 4 to 6 inches. Yeah, I know. I got a lot of them with big roots on them. I haven't had any green tops yet. My rows aren't quite rows anymore.
got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bags left. Naturalizing. Well, let's hope they do. Just naturalize their oak pieces. That has a big sprout on him. There's that one. Hard to show them in the dirt where you walk. Tuesday, December 13th. It's 48 degrees outside, and we're having a blast. Doing what we like to do. Now, check out this little bugger. He got cut in half.
Oh, he did. Did he grow?
I don't know. There's no roots on it. Probably not. They harvest these things like potatoes. Great big old digger machine pulled by a tractor. So. There's bound to be casualties.
All right, so
I just got this little corner over here, so that'll be about 3 bags in there, which will work out just perfect. I bet we're gonna run out. Cause you've only got 50 left, and I've only got. I've only got a dozen. Yeah, you're pretty close to it.
Well, I thought we were gonna have much for that. Okay.
I
little area right there.
See how it looks when we're done. Right now, I think it's looking great. About 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 or 10 bulbs. Yep, I'm just going to show her the whole thing. I'm going to use the compost mulch right on top, and then I'm going to use the unground mulch over everything. One more.
Oh, here's one here. No, that's the front row. Yes, these are the front row.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, we don't need them on the walkway. Perfect. Yeah, shove it in there beside you. They're close to him. Whatever.
Okay.
Perfect. Looks great. Yep, that looks just fine. I don't see two back there that could be moved over. But they'll be okay. Cover them up with mulch, this project will be done.
with the in-ground. This can be 4 or 5 inches, and then I'm gonna put another 3 inches of this up on. By springtime, it'll all compress down to 4 or 5 inches thick. A little better camera angle here. I mean, it looks thick now, but by springtime, by the time it freezes and thaws, it's going to be compressed big time. I don't know, I might have got it a little deeper. Don't have to put the unground mulch on top of this. Bulb there. Oh, just okay. So that's the walkway right there at the end of the board, right? It's a little deep. heavy. It is considerably heavier, and it's right here. You want to trade it?
No, brother.